Hey guys, LP Cricket here, back with another episode of Hellblade. Last time we left off, we made it to a tree by following Dillion, and we found Sigmund's fabled sword, or at least an imagination of it. We were told by our guide, I'm spacing his name, but there are five or six different points, places where we are going to have to be tested to gather the different pieces of the sword so that we can hopefully forge those together and go and fight Hela again, since we got trashed the last time we attempted that. So, let's go ahead and get into this. We'll see how many of these trials we'll be able to complete in this time. My last episode was a little long since it had been a while, so I'll probably keep this one at the regular time around 30 to 45 minutes, but we'll see.
As Sigmund and Sinfjotli are being buried alive, Sigmund's sister throws an armful of straw into the grave mound. Hidden in the straw is Sigmund's sword, the gift of Odin. They cut their way out of the grave. And here is the end of Sigmund's story. He was a fierce and great warrior who fought many battles. But one day, an old man came onto the battlefield, although shadowed by a hood. Sigmund struck him with the sword shattered into pieces. Sigmund knew that this was Odin, and thus the victory could not be won. An illusion. It shattered into shards long ago. It is said a great warrior can reforge Gramr by answering the trials of Odin, one for each shard. The roots of the Tree of Death will take you to new lands where you will face the trials.
Go to the shards. Go to the shards.
Go to the shards.
What's the shard? Find it.
It's the metal runestones.
Find it. There it is.
Focus.
There's the shard. Focus.
Focus.
Use your eyes. Look.
Get closer.
What can you see?
Go to it. It's not safe.
I want to tell you a story about a god of the Northmen called Baldur.
What can you see?
The second son of Odin. He was beautiful, good, and wise. He was fair of feature. He spoke fair words. He gave fair judgments. Light shone from him. Only good things were told of him. Yet he was the first of the gods to die.
It's another world. It's lighter.
It's nicer. I like it here. Can we stay?
The bridge. It's not broken.
It's fixed. You can feel me. You need the runes to fight Dillion. You need Dillion. He's waiting for you.
He always said he'd wait.
He's close.
He cares about you.
Open the gate.
She can't.
Open the gate.
It's locked. Try harder.
She can't.
The gate.
She can't.
She can't. She will.
World.
Go through it.
It's dangerous.
Follow it. What's behind the gate?
Where will it take you?
It's not safe. Dillion.
There he is.
There he is.
What are you waiting for?
Quick, find a way.
Find him.
Go through him.
Before he disappears.
Where is he?
Where's he gone?
We're in the wrong world.
He's not here.
She's in the wrong world.
He's not in this world.
He's in the other one.
He's in the other one.
He's in the dark world.
The world once seemed so simple. Black and white. Darkness and light. Narrow dividing lines of our own making. Dillion taught her to see further. To peek through the cracks and see the worlds of color stretching away from the gloom.
Not in this world.
And Senno explored new paths into the unknown.
The Northmen tell this story about the death of Baldur. It begins with dark dreams. Night after night, Baldur dreams of his own death, and the gods fear for his life. So Baldur's mother makes everything in the world, fire, water, iron, stone, earth, wood, beasts, birds, serpents, poison, sickness, swear an oath not to harm her sons. One by one, they each make their vow. Neither weapons nor wood will injure him, Baldur's mother boasts. Only Loki, father of Hela, the mistress of death, is not amused.
Dillion's the only reason she's still alive.
Okay, the symbol must be somewhere.
Do you remember what it was to touch him?
I don't know if I'm gonna have to go up higher.
Does it feel warm? Do you feel safe? Dillion loves you.
I'm gonna have to go up.
You killed him. He couldn't see the darkness within you.
Nobody will ever.
Can you remember what love feels like?
Look what happens to the thing
she
likes.
She destroys the thing. You have no chance for love now.
Nobody will love you again.
Ever. Ever again.
You can't.
Was it worth it?
You're still alive and Dillian's dead.
He doesn't deserve to be dead. How does that make you feel?
Okay. I think we're gonna have to find the symbol here to open the door and make it possible to get in here when it's raining.
He's the reason she keeps fighting.
Oh my gosh.
Senua, you can't.
Why isn't he here?
That took four.
He's gone. He's in the dark world. He's gone to the dark world.
You're in the wrong world.
He's in the other world.
The dark world.
Without you.
Back, switch worlds, get through, I can go up the stairs, explore around up on the second floor.
Your love because he believed in you.
So you're still open? There we go.
There he is.
Where are you taking
him? He's up there.
How do you get up?
There's a way. There is a way up there.
Find the way.
She can do it.
The gods feast and rejoice and amuse themselves by throwing spears and stones at Baldur, striking at him with sword and axe. But he comes to no harm, whatever they do. The gods never cease to wonder at this great marvel. But Loki shapes himself into a woman and asks Baldur's mother, "Is it really true that all things promise to keep him safe?" "I did not ask the mistletoe," Baldur's mother confesses. "I thought it was too young." Oh dears. Loki makes a dart out of mistletoe and goes to the gods as they throw things at Baldur. The blind god, Hoth, was there. Loki asks him why he wasn't taking part. Hoth says, "I cannot..."
Years have passed since she left her father. She trained hard alongside her friend, Dillian. She saw things no one else could. Patterns, shapes, movement. An an intuition that made her an exceptional warrior. Friendship turned to love. But the shadow of darkness never let her go, and she was caught between two worlds. That of Zinbel, and Dillian, a future. Two realities tearing at her soul.
Why didn't she listen to her father?
She thought she could defy her father.
Wasting your time.
You have no time for this. Speed up.
These rooms mean nothing. It's all part of their game.
They've set your trials to distract you.
They've set you up, and now they're going to watch you.
What if these trials
mean nothing? I interrupted that story of Baldur. I'm going to restart that. For those of you who are interested, as I am,
letting this get in the way.
Loki makes a dart out of mistletoe and goes to the gods as they throw things at Baldur. The blind god, Hoth, was there. Loki asks him why he wasn't taking part. Hoth says, I cannot see where Baldur stands, and even if I could see him, I have no weapon. Loki replies, here is a wand.
There I go, interrupting again. Anyway, it sounds like it is going to be the end of Baldur.
The Northmen tell how the gods mourned Baldur.
Yep.
His body was to be burnt on his ship, but they could not manage to push it into the sea and sent for a giantess to do it. She comes riding a wolf and has vipers for her wings. She pushes Baldur's ship into the sea with such force that the ground shakes and the rollers burst into flames. When Baldur's wife sees his body carried onto the ship, her heart bursts with grief, and she dies. She's put next to her husband, and the pyre is lit, sending the dead to hell. But even so, the gods cannot accept his death.
Do you remember the way he stroked your hair?
Do you remember the way he felt?
She had light within her when she left.
She is pure darkness.
What if this is pointless?
What are you doing?
Overcome with grief, the gods send Hermod to ride to Hel and ask Hela to let Baldur return home. All the gods are weeping, he says. Are they? Asks Hela. We shall see if he is truly missed. If everything in the world will weep for him, he shall go back to the gods. But if even one thing refuses, Baldur stays with me. The gods send messengers everywhere. Weep for Baldur, weep him out of hell. And everything wept. Men, beasts, earth, stone, trees, metal, everything. Except for a giantess they found in a cave.
He saw the warrior.
Baldur was never my friend, she says. Let hell keep what she has. The Northmen say that the giantess must have been Loki in disguise.
What if they're all about waiting?
gods are just playing. What if the gods are laughing?
Dillian!
Messing with her.
It wouldn't be this.
Alright, tightrope.
Dillian never much cared for the underworld. You're going to fall. And looked dimly upon the druids, like her father, Zinbal. I guess he took after his father, a chieftain who believed nothing he couldn't see. And he happened to be blind. She felt safe in Dillian's arms, and to see the world through his eyes. And slowly, the darkness that had bound her so tightly began to unravel.
Be quick. Be careful. Don't fall down.
Senua, your father cannot understand your darkness. He cannot see through your eyes. No one can. My own father was born blind. Doesn't have the faintest idea of what the night looks like. The word dark to him means as little as the word light. So someone is afraid of the dark. Should we fix them by taking away their sight? Would you give up the beautiful world that you, and only you, can see just to be rid of your nightmares? Or is this the price you pay for the gift you have? The gift that makes you so special in my eyes. Just another part of the person I love.
I left for the wilds to protect you from my darkness. Because I love you. But it made it worse. I'm so sorry.
It's done. You did it. But there's more. There's more.
You're tired, but you have to keep going.
There's still more.
There's always more to do.
It's not going to be easy.
Can we do another one? It's too
on to number two.
She hasn't got the energy.
No.
I saw once a plague strike northern lands of ice. It was so terrible that not the oldest man among us could remember the like. Hundreds died. The sickness took nearly every person younger than 40, and many older. And where dying mothers gave birth, the marks of the plague were on the babes as they came out of the womb.
Where are we? I don't like it. This place feels...
What is this place?
This place feels... it's... creepy.
Creepy indeed.
It feels wrong. It feels strange. Where is it? Where are we?
Turn back.
There he is. There
Dillian.
He is.
The light.
Go towards him.
He's in the house.
Find
He's going
him.
In.
He's disappearing.
Follow him.
Don't let him disappear.
The air. Where's it gone?
Keep going.
How do you find it? It's just a trial.
It's just another test.
You just have to solve it, and then you will find him.
Then you will succeed.
He's so close.
It's just one little test.
Squishy shoes.
It's a test. Like the old warrior trials. Dillian will help me.
Just looking for more stories.
Rot. She can almost taste it. Do you smell it? No. Not everyone can. It was a warm spring day when she went to the river with Dillian and the others. But the water... She could taste the rot. But no one else could. She knew something was wrong. Something sinister. She begged them to leave, but they just laughed at her. But soon enough, as the bodies piled up, no one was laughing. And they knew that she was not like them.
The bridge. It's broken. Fix it.
You have to fix it. How are you going to fix it?
You can't get to the house until the bridge is fixed.
You must. You have to get...
Now you have to find him. Quick, get to the house. Get to the house and finish this trial.
It doesn't finish until you get to the house.
Before he disappears, Senua,
you have to get him.
That is supposed to fix that bridge. There's some ladders up here.
The Northmen speak of a death moon, a light shaped like a half moon that appears inside a house and goes around the walls. I once saw the death moon appear at a farm, and first the shepherd died, then a guest died, and then the farmhand, and then the farmer and six of his men drowned at sea. But that is not the end of it, because the dead return to haunt the living. If you see the death moon, then beware, because there will be death in that house.
She did it.
She did it. You fixed the bridge.
You fixed it.
You passed the trial. Get to the house.
Oh, ye of little faith. It. Rotten bodies everywhere. Nasty.
Senua! Come to me! Where are you?
I'm here! I'm right here!
Are you in there? Come out if you are.
Where is he? Find him.
You have to find him.
The runes.
Focus.
Focus on the runes.
Focus.
Dillian! They're coming for me!
It's close. It's close. Move away. Run!
Run now!
Oh boy. Oh boy. Oh boy.
What shall I do?
The light. Go towards it. Focus.
Focus. Focus.
Look.
Run. Run. Or just catch on fire. Suck.
There it is. Huh? It's close. It's close. Move away. Senua, move away.
I feel it.
You'll die.
Quiet.
You're dying. The burning
She's
has begun.
Dying. The burning.
The burning has begun.
Go to the gate. There they are. The rooms.
One more to find. One more. One more.
Dancing. Find the
others.
Run.
Achievement I just got, cure the plague. That's probably why there's so many dead bodies.
Senua!
Torch the city, try and take care of the plague from
spread. Senua! What happened?
They're blaming me for the plague. They say that I'm cursed. What if they're right?
How would they know such a thing? Are they gods? None of us are. They're just people. Good people, but they're scared. They're afraid of what they can't see. Like children scared of the dark. They make up stories to fill the void.
What if my father was right?
You have to step out of this darkness. Let them see who you really are, like I have. You're not a monster.
Made me a monster.
What if this is pointless? What if you're wrong?
What if this has nothing to do with the sword?
What if we're wrong?
The sword will never be yours.
What if this is the end?
It's just a trick.
It's just. Tell me more of these shards.
You've been fooled before.
Play.
You could be fooled again.
Game.
So it's just
you
two.
Never know which way it's going to go.
Okay. I think I'm going to go ahead and stop the video there for now. Halfway. Got two more to go. After that, we'll have the sword be able to put it together and go find Hela. So, having a brain fart. Anyway, hope you guys are still enjoying the series. I'm still loving all of the mythology that the creators and developers have thrown into the game. The ability that you can have Senua's backstory, learn more about her and her character and kind of the struggles she's gone through, but then also learn about the mythology from the time period, the Norse gods and the different stories that existed from back then, because those are very interesting to listen to if you've never gotten the chance to. But if you guys are enjoying the videos, like, comment, subscribe to my channel. I'll continue to put these out, along with some other games that we're playing. I'll be putting this video up here pretty quickly. And I will see you guys for the next video. Bye.